My name is Michelle Miller. I'm running for District 2 Commissioner of the Georgia Public Service Commission. And I want to share a little bit of information about me and then lead into policy. The first thing you should know is that I was born in New Orleans, Louisiana. I was raised in Marrero, Louisiana. And I was born to a very disadvantaged family, very low education. We had drugs and alcohol in the family. And when I was a young child, my band teacher, Mr. Myers, on my birthday, took me to Oakwood Mall. We sat down and we ate chocolate cake watching over 70 people fly kites. And he told me, Michelle, you can fly as high as that kite as long as you have passion for what you're doing. And all the tools you need to be successful is already inside of you. This literally set me on fire. I felt he handed me the keys to my freedom. And guess what I did? I became an opera singer. I learned how to play 3 different instruments. I was on a TV program called Our Generation with Sally Ann Roberts on Channel 4 News talking about community issues. By the age of 16, my first airplane ride was to Washington, D.C., where I represented the state of Louisiana in the National Bicentennial Competition. I debated members of Congress and a Supreme Court justice on the Bill of Rights and the Constitution. I felt as though they planted a seed in me. They passed that proverbial torch onto me so that one day I can stand up and serve my community. Also, by the age of 16, I became an emancipated minor. I left Louisiana. I moved to Bellevue, Nebraska, where I used to work at Burger King until 3 o'clock in the morning, going to high school at 6:30 in the morning. Never was I on welfare, never was I was on Medicaid. I knew that if I worked hard and I kept focused, I can be successful. So let me tell you what I did with those seeds. I nourished that seed with education. I'm a Penn State graduate in energy and sustainability policy. I won a scholarship with Penn State to Costa Rica with the Green Program, where I studied geothermal, biomass, solar, wind, biofuel, and I'm certified in ArcGIS, which is transmission siting, line siting, route optimization, metadata analysis. I'm certified as an ethical leader in business and policy from the NASPA Center for the Public Trust. I've consulted internationally in China, France, here at home. I even won a military contract with Brook City Base in Texas. So I am very well prepared to work for you on day one. So let me tell you what the PSC does. The Public Service Commission, we regulate electric, natural gas, and telecommunications, but I'm here to tell you we can do so much more. We can be your financial steward and investor. We can be your advocate, and we can be your educator. If everyone underneath the sound of my voice can do me a favor, can you raise one hand for me? And I want you to repeat after me. Can you say, I am a shareholder? Oh, come on. I know you have much more Republican spirit than that. Can you say, I am a shareholder?
I am a shareholder.
Thank you. The reason why I brought you through this exercise is because every single time you pay taxes, every single time that you pay your electric bill, you are investing in the state of Georgia. You are investing in the Public Service Commission, and that makes you a shareholder. That means that as your Public Service Commissioner, I am accountable to you. I am accountable to be your financial steward and investor. Let's talk about that for a moment. Every single time that we make an investment, we need to make sure that you have a positive return because it's your money. That's what fiscal conservative is all about, how to spend wisely and how to reduce debt. But we don't do that on the Public Service Commission. We rubber stamp all those rate increases, don't we? The second thing is that we need to be your advocate. You know, I went to the PSC, I read 5.5 years of transcripts, and I realized that we don't talk to your communities before we pass a $6.9 billion rate increase or a $145 million rate increase. We don't see how you're faring. So what I started to do was call county commissioners around Georgia, and believe me, there's a lot of them. 159 counties times 5, that's a lot of people. But what I discovered is that they haven't heard from your public service commissioner at all. We don't talk to them. And I want to know what's happening with you. And in talking with them, I also realized another problem, which is we don't share information. You see, energy is much more dynamic than how much we pay for it and how much we consume it. It can really be a money saver in your community. It can be a job creator in your community. It can be a tax revenue generator. And I'm going to give you some examples how. Every community make money on the water and lose money on the sewage. Did y'all know that? They do, every community. If you put an energy technology on your water treatment facility, you can eliminate the electric costs. That cost savings can be $200,000 or more, money we can redirect into your budget for much more needed services. Now let me ask you a question. How many water treatment facilities in Georgia do you think have an energy technology on them? None. That's information that can save you money. Secondly, there's another thing that we can do. Do you remember, if you want to attract businesses to your community, what's the first thing your community must do? Do you know? Give tax credits, right? That's your money. What if the public service commissioner works with your local officials and your public utility? So if a business want to move to your area, we can allow them an exemption to finance an energy technology on their buildings. If you have 14 hotels, for example, with a 1 megawatt on each hotel, that's 14 megawatts. And the deal would be, written in the contract, those businesses would have to revert that energy back to the main grid during high peak demand times, which is the most costliest times for your public utility. That's from 5 to 7 a.m. in the morning and from 5 p.m. to 9 o'clock p.m. roughly. So what would happen is the businesses, through that cost savings, can expand more quickly. They can hire more people in your community. Those people have paychecks. They go out and they spend money, which will increase tax revenues. Because all of the businesses who have the energy technologies are reverting that energy back to the main grid, now your public utility have downward pressure on electric bills. Your bills go down. That is what a small government is. It's collaboration. It's us working together in partnership to make sure that we're spending money wisely and we're using technology efficiently. My name is Michelle Miller. I'm running for District 2 Commissioner of the Georgia Public Service Commission. Even though it's a District 2 post, it is a statewide election. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to email me, text me, or call me. I'll have information, push cards, and business cards there for you. Can I take any questions, or? No. Can you see me?